tomb was a labor of love. A brother had come to me, a couple of brothers, they wanted to do a movie on my life. But I didn't trust them, I didn't like them, I didn't like their energy, I didn't like what they were directing me towards. Because I'm more than a photographer. I'm more than a documentary. And I didn't feel that they were capturing the spirit that I wanted to pass on when I'm gone in a film. Films last. People make copies and so I was talking to a brother, and that brother said, "Trust me, I'll make a movie." I said, "Have you ever made a movie before?" He said, "No. But I know you, I know your heart, and I'll make a movie." I trusted him, I respected him, and I loved him. And he would do his thing. He never called me for information. He never called me to ask questions. And when he called me to watch the movie, I said, "I can't watch the movie by myself. I have to be in a room with people and see their reaction. That's really where you get the knowledge of what a movie's about." So he tricked me because he said he needed help with editing and he forced me to watch part of the movie. I couldn't watch it, so I actually left the room. And the night that we showed the movie was at the Tribeca Film Festival, which was run by Robert De Niro. And the people invited us to a party afterwards, but I didn't feel like I was a part of it. I didn't feel like being around all the Hollywood types and De Niro and all that, so I didn't go. The next morning, early in the morning, if you know the movie Wild Style and Style Wars, I got a phone call from those people telling me, "Congratulations." I said, "On what?" He said, "I'm winning the Tribeca Film Festival." And I said, "What?" They said, "Yeah, you won last night." I said, "That's incredible." Because if you notice, no native has ever won anything in Hollywood, ever. Except John Wayne and all that. And no hip hop film has ever won anything. This is a combination of both. So I made a blow for both. So the movie was literally a labor of love. And there are some people in this movie who actually, without getting too deep now, they channeled this energy. How many of you seen my videos on YouTube? Any of you? Okay, all of you. Okay. Then you know that hip hop didn't start in 74. It's eternal vibe. These people channeled that energy, channeled that vibe. Afrika Bambaataa, Chuck D, a lot of people. Those people in the film, they're giving me respect, not for me as a human being, but for my work, for my energy, for my love, for my labor. Because when it's time for you to leave, nobody judges you by what you had. They judge you by what you gave. And they judge you by what you did for others. That's really what this movie is about, how you can take nothing, make something, and empower the people around you with it. And that's the message that I want to make. So enjoy the movie.